Speaker has covered variety of topics, specifically Section 3 and Section 4 of the Workmen Compensation Act, which has been nowadays called as an Employees Compensation Act 1923. Now, as far as this act is concerned, this is a pre-constitutional legislation. Before the constitution came into force, it is in British era this act has been enacted. But we can find out the relevance of this act even today, because this is the very best, or rather we can say the best piece of social legislation. The constitution specifically under the preamble highlighted, enshrined various principles of social, economical and political justice. So when we talk about this social and political justice, or social and economical justice, this is the best example. That is, or rather we can say all the industrial laws in India, labor laws in India, are specifically highlighting the specific preamble and the objective which has been enshrined in the preamble. Apart from that, the constitution also speaks about some justice for the everyone, that is Article 14, we can refer over here. Article 39 specifically provides for, it's a directive principle of state policy. So you, all of you are aware of the directive principle of state policy. Article 37 says that even they are non-justiciable, they are fundamental in the governance of the country. And Article 39 cast a very, very important obligation on the government to guide their policy, to frame their policy for the upliftment of the economical and social, rather we can say the weaker sections of the society. Considering all this constitutional provision, we can further move towards this particular workman compensation, rather we can say the Employees Compensation Act of 1923. There are major amendments which has been done, more than 20 to 25 amendments are being made under this particular act, as we consider this a very old legislation. Now the major aspect of this act, or the basis, basic point we can say over here, is that this act has been enacted for the benefits of the workman. Employees. So the first point that is to be pointed out is that the while granting the compensation or claiming the compensation, the relationship between the two is employer and the employee. Right, sir? So the basic point is that unless and until there's a relationship is not there, the person cannot claim any relief under the act. So how this particular relationship is being established? Now the Supreme Court has in various judgments has given a specific verdict that even a casual worker who has been, you know, employed a day, within a day, or suppose unfortunately he meets with an accident in a first day, he is entitled to get a compensation under this act. This is the one of the major advantage of this particular legislation, we can say. Now, moving for other aspects like, as sir has rightly pointed out, Section 4 of this act categorically laid down some fixed wage amount of compensation that can be provided to the this workman. Now, as far as the scheme of the act is concerned, whether this is a charity to the workman? No, this is not charity or some sort of sympathetic, you know, the treatment given to the workman. Rather, we can say this is the right, legal right of a workman to get a compensation. Why? Because he is the ultimate contributor to the production of the industry, and that is why he is entitled to get whatever unfortunate accidents which arises while in the during of in the course of employment or the during the course of employment, he is entitled for the compensation. And that is why earlier, as I have pointed out, length of the service doesn't matter, or it is an irrelevant factor, and the person is entitled to get a compensation even if he is a new worker or employee. Now considering this aspect, one more legislation is that, that is the Employee State Insurance Act of 1948. It is a very wide legislation as compared to the Workmen Compensation Act. But the person who has been covered under the Employees Insurance Act will not get a compensation under the Workmen Compensation Act. Now the basic principle on which this whole compensatory act, Workmen Compensation Act, is based is the cost of the product should bear the blood of the workman. This is the basic principle. Now, as far as this Workman Compensation Act is concerned, it's a very beneficial piece of legislation, security and as well as the important economic legislation is there. But at the same time, the act is highlighting more on the preventive and cure aspects of it. But one more aspect is being introduced by the various jurists in this area is the some sort of rehabilitation. This aspect has never been considered in Indian legislation as far as this Workman Compensation Act is concerned. Now, what is this rehabilitation? We are talking about the economic rehabilitation of a workman.